Welcome to my YouTube channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. In this video, we will talk about the cholinergic transmission. Neurotransmission refers to the transmission of neural impulse from one neuron to another neuron or to an effector organ like muscles or glands by releasing chemical substances called neurotransmitters. When acetylcholine is used as a neurotransmitter for transmitting impulses, then this type of neurotransmission is called cholinergic transmission. And this type of neurotransmission occurs in the autonomic ganglia, all parasympathetic neuroeffector synapses, and in some of the sympathetic neuroeffector synapses, for example, sweet glands, sympathetic innervation, and peripheral nervous system. Basically, cholinergic transmission involves six steps. For this, here I'm zooming into this synapse in which acetylcholine is used as a neurotransmitter. This is a neuron here, and it is its presynaptic axon terminal. And this is the postsynaptic side, while this is the synaptic left-right. The first step in the cholinergic transmission is the synthesis of acetylcholine. Choline is a quaternary ammonium compound that is transported into the exoplasm of the cholinergic neuron by an energy-dependent carrier system that co-transport sodium and choline. The transporter involved in this process is called the choline transporter. Choline inside the cholinergic neuron reacts with acetyl coenzyme A to form acetylcholine in the cytosol. In the presence of cytosolic enzyme, choline acetyltransferase. This is the chemical structure of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, just for understanding, okay? The second step in the cholinergic transmission is the storage of acetylcholine in vesicles. After synthesis, acetylcholine is transported into synaptic vesicles by the vesicular acetylcholine transporter, where it is stored in granules. The vesicles are attached via the protein synapsin to the cytoskeleton network. This arrangement helps in bunching of vesicles near the presynaptic membrane while preventing their fusion with it. The third step is the release of acetylcholine. The arrival of action potential at presynaptic nerve terminal triggers calcium influx into exoplasm of neuron by opening of voltage-gated calcium channels, which result in increased calcium level in the exoplasm of neuron, which in turn activate protein kinases that phosphorylates synapsin. As a result, vesicles close to the membrane are detached from their attaching, and in turn, this vesicular membrane fuses with the presynaptic membrane. And lastly, the exocytotic ejection of acetylcholine occurs in the synaptic left. The next step is the binding of acetylcholine to its receptors. Released acetylcholine diffuses across the synaptic left and binds to postsynaptic receptors on the target neurons or effector site like muscles or glands. Binding of acetylcholine to a receptor leads to a biologic response within the cell, such as the initiation of a neural impulse in a postganglionic fiber or activation of specific enzymes in effector cells. While here, some neurotransmitter binds to receptors on the presynaptic site, which in turn inhibit the additional release of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine into the synaptic cleft. The next step is the degradation of acetylcholine. The signal at the postsynaptic effector site is rapidly terminated because the released neurotransmitter acetylcholine is rapidly metabolized into choline and acetate by the action of acetylcholine esterase, which is found in the synaptic cleft. The last step is the recycling of choline. Choline may be recaptured by a high affinity transport system into the neuron, where it is acetylated and stored until released by subsequent action potential. Lastly, hemicholinium is a drug which blocks choline uptake into the exoplasm by interfering with the choline transporter. While the active transport of acetylcholine into synaptic vesicles is affected by another carrier, which is blocked by vesomicol. Besides this, botulinum toxin inhibits the release of the neurotransmitter acetylcholine, while black virus spider toxin induces massive release and eventually depletion of acetylcholine. While here, cholinergic antagonists inhibit the binding of acetylcholine to the cholinergic receptors. In contrast, cholinergic agonists bind to these receptors and show actions like that of acetylcholine. And with this, thanks for watching and support us by